Hello and welcome back for a new video. This is Marine for Land Fun, and today's card features the small Year 10 stamp set. Here's a quick look at the stamp and die sets I used to create this card. So the Year 10 stamp set, Critters Down Under, Blue Skies, Hats Off to You, Dad and Me, the Large Stitch Rectangle Stackable Die Set, the Stitch Simple Wavy Border Die Set, and finally, the Magic Picture Changer Die Set and Add-on. When I make a Magic Picture Changer card, I like to start with a 5.5 by 4.25 inches stitch panel to create the background. And for this card, I used Squeezed Lemonade, Spiced Marmalade, Abandoned Coral and Candied Apple Distressings. I started by applying Squeezed Lemonade on most of the panel to get a nice and even base. Next, I added Spiced Marmalade from the top towards the center and blended it into the yellow base. To darken the background, I also applied some Abandoned Coral that I blended into the Spiced Marmalade section. And finally, I added a little bit of Candied Apple at the very top to bring more contrast to this background. Now what's next? Texture, of course. Like always, I started by splattering water on my paper and I dried it using a paper towel. Next, I pressed the Spiced Marmalade, Abandoned Coral and also Mustard Seed ink pads onto my glass mat. I added water to those colors and then I created a million drops on my paper using a thin brush. To ground this little scene, I die-cut two wavy borders and used anti-linen and vintage photo distress inks to create sand borders. And I will use the same inks to create splatters on those borders. Next, I moved on to the interactive part of my card. I cut two pieces of Strathmore Bristol cardstock, a long panel for the pocket die and a short one for the moving piece die. I marked the windows using a pencil and next I moved on to the stamping. On the long panel, I stamped the cacti only. And I always like to use my Misty tool so I can stamp the image twice and this way get a perfect impression. On the short panel, I placed the cacti and the flower on top. With the door of my Misty tool, I picked up the flower only. I removed the cacti and stamped the flower. And I did the same thing for the two other flowers. Next, I cut masks for the flowers using the coordinating die. I placed the cacti on top and stamped it. I also cut masks for the two cacti using the coordinating die and off-screen I used the same inks as before to create backgrounds on both panels. I removed the masking paper and because of those masks, some of the lines were not connected, so I simply used my Memento pen to join all the lines. And next, I colored the images using my alcohol markers like always. When the coloring was done, I added white highlights on the images using my Wachel pen. I taped the dies on the panels and sent everything to my die-cut machine. On the long panel, I started by folding the tabs using a bone folder in order to make them very flat. I applied double-sided tape on those tabs, front and back, and next I removed the backing paper from the inside and I folded the tabs to stick them. I applied powder on the flaps and also along the tabs to help the mechanism to work nicely. I folded the panel in half on the score line. Next, I put the moving piece into the pocket panel through the slit, and I put each flap into a small slit like so. I pulled on the tab to interlock the pieces. I made sure everything was aligned between the tabs. And finally, I removed the backing paper and folded the pocket panel to totally close it. Next, I took my background panel and cut a frame out of it. I applied a thin double-sided tape at the back of it on the four edges, and then I attached this frame to the pocket. Now to the card base. I cut it out of paperback cardstock and I stuck the remaining pieces of the background as well as the pocket on this card base using foam tape and double-sided tape. And before moving on to the coloring, I attached the sand borders, and on the smaller one, I stamped my sentiment. This sentiment is part of the Year 10 stamp set. So I stamped some additional images. For the hats, I just used the bottom of this image and then I drew the Mexican hats myself. First using a pencil and I went back on the lines using my Memento pen. When the coloring was done, I fussy cut the hats and used the coordinating dies to cut the other images. And you can notice that I also added a moustache on each cacti. I thought it would make them cuter. So when everything was attached, I added white highlights on the images and I cut the tab handle out of chili pepper cardstock. I stuck it at the very top of the tab and for the arrow I used sunflower cardstock. And we are done, this is the final result. So what do you think about those Mexican hats? They're not perfect, but I think they're very cute and they totally make the card more interesting. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time. Bye!